Hello. NanoLuc is very bright. What good is that brightness? It's to see how low you can go. NanoLuc is 100-fold brighter than either firefly or Ranilla luciferases. This means you need 100-fold fewer molecules of NanoLuc to get a measurable signal. This also means you can use NanoLuc as the reporter in your cells at near physiological levels, getting you closer to the true biology. To illustrate this, let's look at P53 regulation. P53 is constantly made, but its availability is regulated by MDM2. MDM2 binds to P53 and marks it for degradation by the proteasome. When an appropriate signal, like DNA damage, is received, the MDM2 is removed and the P53 is freed to do its work. Effectively, DNA damage stabilizes the P53 protein. We found that we could witness this stabilization event with a P53 NanoLuc construct. Treatment with etoposide, a DNA damaging agent, induced the stabilization of the fusion. The key part of this experiment is not, could we make a P53 NanoLuc fusion? It was, could we express this fusion at a low enough level to be regulated by MDM2, yet still be measurable? Imagine the cell having 1,000 copies of MDM2. Overexpression of the NanoLuc fusion could easily overwhelm that few molecules. We needed the expression level of the fusion to approach physiological levels of P53. If we ever hope to see the stabilization event. Could we have done this with the P53 firefly fusion? Doubtful. Why? It all goes back to brightness. We would need 100-fold more firefly fusion to gain the same measurable signal we see with the NanoLuc fusion. That much firefly fusion would overwhelm the MDM2 and seem more like just P53 overexpression. To learn more about what you could do with NanoLuc, please see the links below. Thank you.